Are you hear my voice? Is there any problem in my audio and video? Video is okay. Voice is lower. Dear students, any problem in my audio and video? Audio is okay. Yeah, video. Yes, thank you. Thank you all. And look at that, our midterm syllabus. Coming Saturday, no test, okay? Coming Saturday, no test for you. Max test. For coming Saturday, no max test for you. Okay. And midterm portion, chapter 1, 2, and 3. Right. The question paper pattern, section A, 25 one mark questions. Okay. Section B, 5 into 2 marks, 10 marks. Section C, 5 into 3 marks, 15, totally 50 marks. Okay, it was section A having MCQs, fill-ups, short answers. Okay, section A totally 25 one mark questions. In this 25 one marks, we have some MCQs, fill-ups, short answers, everything. Okay. And for MCQs, you write the question number, option, and answer also. If the answer is 5 by 2 means answer also. Write the question number, option, and answer also. You have to write all the three properly. Okay. If you are not writing any one is not properly, then mark will not be given. Okay, so there are a lot of issues in this. So therefore, write the question number properly, write the option properly, write the answer also, corresponding answer also. Okay, and leave some space for one question and the second question, leave some space. Many of the students are writing like this. Okay, they are writing like this, 3 pi by 2. So don't write like this. Leave some space for the second question. For the first question is A, 5 by 2 is the answer. Then leave some space. Then come to the next. Some B, some cos X or tan X or sin X. Write the answer, option and answer also. And come to the third one. Okay, and C, write everything. Okay, right. So for the MCQs, it is your wish to write the answer alone or explanations. Okay, but for the fill-ups and short answers, you have to write the explanations. Okay, for fill-ups and short answers, write the explanation, because from short answer question, some prove that question will be there, find the value will be there. So therefore, you have to find the value or prove the some simple formula or result, whatever it is. Okay, we have to write the explanation properly, right? Suppose, sir, I know the first question, sir. I don't know the second question, sir. Then what to do? Leave some space for the second question and go to the third one and fourth one. Fourth one also, don't know, sir. Leave some space. At the last, you fill up. Even you don't know, sir, I don't know, not at all, the second question, sir. So then leave that blankly. Okay, so no problem, but write your question numbers, questions, answer the questions properly in the same order. Don't change the order. Someone answering for the first one, A answer, some 5 by 2, and seventh one, D answer, none. And again, 3, C answer, some 1 by 2. Okay, don't write like that. Okay, 1, 7, 3, right? So come in order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, if you know the answer, write the answer. Leave some space. If you know the answer, write it. Leave some space. Okay, and fill all the write all the questions. And finally, you try to answer for the omitted questions. That means not answering questions. You please answer the last. Okay, so therefore, write properly. This is very important. And this is our question paper pattern. Okay. Yeah, you can start from 4 marks. There is no 4 marks, only 3 marks. No negative marks. Supraja, what are you asking? They'll get proof from NCERT or out of NCERT? You please get the proof from NCERT only. You can start from section C, no problem. Okay, so that is your choice, ruled paper or unruled paper, that is your choice. But the paper will be a neat and your presentation will be neat and your photo that will be very neat. Okay. Yeah, we will discuss. No, only 20% of the questions from NCERT, remaining 80% outside the NCERT only. When you are writing your exam, you have to close your Max book, Max notebooks and other books. Without seeing any book, you have to write the answers. Okay, that is very important one. Right? No deleted portions. Deleted portions, deleted only. I have told many, many, many times. Deleted portions, deleted only. We never teach that. We never ask any questions from that deleted portions. Okay? You please omit the deleted portions. I repeat that. What are the deleted portions for the chapter 1? In chapter 1, complement of a set. Okay, A complement and properties and complement properties. That is deleted. Deleted portions. Okay, chapter 2. In chapter 2, the algebra functions. What is algebra functions? Means sum of two functions, subtraction of two functions, multiplication of two functions, FG, division of two functions, everything. This is deleted. Okay, in my third chapter, general solution of sin x is equal to sin y, cos x is equal to cos y, tan x equal to tan y. These are deleted topics in the first 3 chapters. Okay, so therefore you don't concentrate these deleted chapters. You please graph questions also. Difference of two sets. In the first one, we have one more topic, difference of two sets. Difference of two sets means A minus B. This is a difference of two sets. Operation on sets. We have union operation, we have intersection operation. We have complement operation, we have a difference operation, but this difference operation and complement operation omitted. Only we have union and intersection. Okay. Up to R cross R means up to R cross R, there is no more R cross R. Three dimension. Up to R cross R means, okay. So we have to find the Cartesian product up to 3. R cross R, up to. That is not deleted. Okay. Right. Now come to the homework problems. Some of the students are asking doubts in homework problems, but many of the homework problems from even your book only. Right. So now look at that. Through that, I think this is one of the problem asked by one student. Cos square x, cos square x plus pi by 3 plus cos square x minus pi by 3. Look at that. So I have a formula for cos x plus cos y. We have formula for cos x plus cos y. What is the formula? So that is 2 cos of x plus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2. This is a formula for 2 cos x plus cos y, cos of x plus y by 2, cos of x minus y by 2. But here, cos square x is there. Cos square x plus 3, cos square x minus 3 is there. So therefore, it is not possible to apply this formula. Then what to do, sir? So we have one formula for this. Cos square x is equal to, 1 plus cos 2x divided by 2. So what, sir? This identity is not at all in our book, sir. We have already discussed so many identities. In this identity not discussed, sir. This is very simple. Look at that. You know this identity, cos 2x is equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. Look at that. I think this is the 14th identity in your book, NCERT book. Identity number 14, cos 2x equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. Okay, from this I can easily find out this. How, sir? You please bring this one to the left hand side. 1 plus cos 2x equal to 2 cos square x. 1 plus cos 2x divided by 2. This is my cos square x. That's all. My cos square x is equal to 1 plus cos 2x by 2. This is the identity. Simple identity, cos square x. Similarly, we can find out sin square x is 1 minus cos 2x by 2. Okay, so that we'll discuss later. Right. So now come to that. I'm going to apply this identity here. My cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x by 2. So therefore, my cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x divided by 2. Plus, here also I'm applying the same identity. 1 plus cos 2. Here, this is my x. Here, cos square x means cos 2 into x. But this is my x, 2 into this x. X plus pi by 3 by 2. Plus, 1 plus cos 2 into x minus pi by 3 by 2. I'm just applying the identity. This identity, cos square x is equal to 1 plus cos 2x divided by 2. Okay, I'm applying for this one and this one and this one. This is considered, this is very x, 2x, 2x. Okay, so therefore, look at that. This can be written as, this is 1 by 2 cos 2x by 2. Here also 1 by 2 plus cos of, this is multiply this, 2x plus 2 pi by 3 by 2. This by 2 is common for both the terms. Here also by 2 is common for both the terms. 1 by 2 plus cos of 2x minus 2 pi by 3 by 2. Okay, right. Now look at that. This is pi by 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. That is nothing but, it is actually this answer is 3 by 2. So this is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is nothing but 3 by 2. Okay, plus look at these terms, this term and this term in this term. In these three, which is common? Here cos 2x by 2, here cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3 by 2, here cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3 by 2. My 1 by 2 is common in all the three terms. Take it commonly. My first term is cos 2x plus, this is cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3, cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3 plus here cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3. Okay. I'm just taking 1 by 2 common in these three terms. I'm getting my cos 2x, cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3, cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3. Right. I'm going to apply cos x plus cos y, this formula. What is my cos x plus cos y formula? Okay. I'm going to apply this formula, cos x plus cos y. What is my cos x plus cos y formula? 2 cos of x plus y by 2. Cos of x minus y by 2. I'm going to apply this formula. I'm going to consider this is my x, and this is my y. Look at that. This is my x. 2x plus 2 pi by 3. I am going to consider this is as x. This is as y. Apply this formula. What happened? My answer is the first term is 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is common. And cos 2x is there first. Here it is there. My cos 2x. Cos 2x. Here this is my x. This is my y. 2 cos of x plus y by 2. 2 cos of 2x plus 2 pi by 3 plus 2x minus 2 pi by 3 whole divided by 2 into cos of this is 2x plus 2 pi by 3 minus 2x minus 2 pi by 3 whole divided by 2. Okay. I am applying the formula 2 cos of x plus y divided by 2 cos of x minus y divided by 2. Now look at that. Here plus 2 pi by 3 plus 2 pi by 3 minus 2 pi by 3 both get cancelled. Here my minus 2x plus 2x get cancelled. So therefore the answer remaining terms are this is 3 by 2, this is 1 by 2, this is cos 2x. Plus this is 2, this is 2x plus 2x. 2x plus 2x is 4x. Cos 4x divided by 2. So therefore this is nothing but 2x. 4x by 2 it is 2x. Into cos of here 2 pi by 3 plus 2 pi by 3. So that is cos of 4 pi by 3 by 2. This 2 is important. Okay, 2 pi by 3 plus 2 pi by 3, that is 4 pi by 3 divided by 2. 4 pi by 3 divided by 2 is nothing but 2 pi by 3. Are you okay? Right, so therefore this is my 3 by 2, this is 1 by 2, this is cos 2x plus this is 2 cos 2x. Okay, into cos 2 pi by 3, what is the value of cos 2 pi by 3? Actually pi by 3 means 60 degree. You know the radian value, pi by 3 means 60 degree. 2 into 60, 120 degree. This is cos 120. What is the value of cos 120? Okay, yeah, minus 1 by 2. So how to find out my cos 2 pi by 3 means this is cos 120 degree. This cos 120 can be written as cos 90 plus 30. 90 means pi by 2. Okay, pi by 2 is coming, then change the function. Sine 30, but this is belongs to the second quadrant. 120 is the second quadrant angle. Second quadrant, my sine cos of second quadrant angle value is negative. So therefore, my sine 30 is 1 by 2 with negative sign. So therefore, my cos of 2 pi by 3 is minus 1 by 2. Okay, so now you cancel this 2 and this 2. Both are in multiplication, 2 and 1 by 2. So therefore, that 3 pi by 3 by 2, 1 by 2. This is cos 2x and this is minus cos 2x. Okay, and these two get cancelled. Okay, and cancel means this is 0. 0 into 1 by 2, it's also 0. So therefore, this is 3 by 2. This is the answer. Look at that. Your right answer is 3 by 2. Are you okay? Are you clear? Any doubt? Right. This problem. Yeah, dear students, I repeat this problem. Please try to understand. I am repeating this problem. Please try to understand. Look at that. Here square is there. Okay. I know we have an identity for cos x plus cos y. But we don't have identity for cos square x plus cos square y. So therefore, using this identity, look at this identity, my cos square x is equal to 1 plus cos 2x by 2. I am applying this identity. My cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x by 2. Here also, I am applying 1 plus cos 2 into this is where x. Actually, this is my x here. 1 plus cos 2 into this x divided by 2. That is identity. Similarly, here also square is there. So therefore, 1 plus cos 2 into this x by 2. Okay. Now look at that. This 2 is common for both the terms. 1 by 2 cos 2x by 2. 1 by 2 cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3 by 2. Here also 1 by 2 plus cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3 by 2. Okay. Here 1 by 2 is there. Here 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2. Adding these 3 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Are 3 times of 1 by 2, 3 by 2. And look at that, in this term and this term and this term, 1 by 2 is common. Take it outside. Remaining cos 2x. Here remaining cos 2x plus 2 pi by 3. Here cos 2x minus 2 pi by 3. I am going to apply for these two, I am going to apply this formula. Cos x plus cos 5. Okay, here there is no square. So therefore, I am going to apply the formula. Cos x plus cos y, consider this is this entire term is your x, this entire term is your y. The formula is 2 cos of x plus y by 2, cos of x minus y by 2. So this is 2 cos of this is x plus y divided by 2. This is actually x minus y divided by 2. Cos of 2 cos of x plus y by 2 into cos of x minus y by 2. Okay, so here 2 pi by 3, 2 pi by 3 cancel, 2x plus 2x is 4, 4x. Actually 2x plus 2x is 4x, 4x by 2, that is 2x. Into cos of, here 2x, 2x cancel, 2 pi by 3 minus of minus plus 2 pi by 3. That is 4 pi by 3, 4 pi by 3 divided by 2, it is again 2 pi by 3. That is 2 times of 2 pi by 3 by 2, 2, 2 cancel, 2 pi by 3 alone, right? What is the 2 pi by 3 value? My 2 pi by 3 means, actually pi by 3 means 60 degree. Look at the radian measure. Okay. Radian measure pi by 3 is equal to, in degree measure, it is 60 degree. 2 into 60 means 120 degree. This 120 can be written as 90 plus 30. I have already told that the quadrant formula pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. Pi by 2 means 90 or 270 is coming. You change the function. Cos can be written as sine of 30. But this is second quadrant angle. My cos of second quadrant angle is negative. So therefore, minus sine 30. My cos of 120 is equal to minus sine of 130. Sine of 30. My sine 30 is 1 by 2. We know that. It is a very simple value. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. So therefore, minus is there. Minus 1 by 2. In place of this cos of 2 pi by 3, I am applying minus 1 by 2. Use this. Okay. So here 2 and 2 get cancelled. Minus 1 into cos 2x minus cos 2x. Here plus cos 2x. This plus cos and plus cos 2x minus cos 2x get cancelled. I am getting answer is 0. Okay, 0 into 1 by 2. What is the answer? 0. So therefore I am getting only 3 by 2. Are you okay, Pa? Now it is clear. So look at that. Do you know the Bodmer's rule? You have already studied in primary classes Bodmer's rule. It is not possible to adding this and this. Okay, 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2, it is, can I write 4 by 2, sir? Do you know Bodmer's rule? What is Bodmer's rule? First of all, we have to do the brackets, operate brackets of division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. Okay, so here multiplication is there. We have to operate these two first. 1 by 2 into this bracket. First of all, we have to simplify this bracket. Okay, bracket, B means bracket. Okay, after that, go for the multiplication. 1 by 2 into this bracket value. After that, come for addition. Are you okay, Pa? Madhunisha, are you okay? Matis also, please try to understand, don't add these two. First of all, multiplication, complete the multiplication and then come to that addition and subtraction. Okay, here multiplication is there, 1 by 2 into this bracket value. My bracket value is 0. 0 into 1 by 2, it is 0. Now add 3 by 2 plus 0. What is the answer? 3 by 2. Don't add these two, 3 by 2, 1 by 2. Use this rule. Okay. Okay, then Shahrukh, what is your doubt? Okay, we will check it. Shahrukh, what is your doubt? 0 plus 3 by 2, 3 by 2 plus 0, both are giving the same answer, Shahrukh. 0 plus 3 by 2, 3 by 2 plus 0, both are giving the same answer, 3 by 2. Are you okay, Pa? Okay, Pa. Yeah. Come to the next problem. Some students are asking doubts in this problem also. If tan x equal to 3 by 4. Find the value of my x lies between pi less than x. 3 by 2. Find the values of sin x by 2. Find the values of sin x by 2, cos x by 2, tan x by 2. Look at that, tan x value given. They are asking about tan of x by 2. Okay, tan x value given, they are asking about tan x by 2. Right. So, first of all, you please note that one important point. What is the point? What is given? Your x is in the third quadrant. Your x lies in the third quadrant. Okay. What about your x by 2? Divide by 2 in both the sides. This is 3 pi by 4. Okay. 3 pi by 4 means 3 into pi by 4. Pi by 4 is 45 degree. 3 into 45 degree. My 3 into 45 degree is nothing but 135 degree. 135. This is 90. This is 135. Yeah, by 2. This is by 2. Okay, which implies my x by 2 lies in the second quadrant. Okay, our x by 2 lies in the second quadrant. Okay, now come to the problem. What is given? My tan x is equal to 3 by 4. We know that one identity, 1 plus tan square x equal to secant square. You know this identity? 1 plus tan square x is equal to secant square. So you know this identity, cos square plus sin square. Divide this by cos square x. What happened? Divide this by cos square x. Cos square x by cos square x. Plus sin square x by cos square x. Okay, this is 1 by cos square x. Divide all the terms by cos square. Cos square by cos square is 1 plus sin square by cos square is tan square x equal to 1 by cos square is secant square. This is the identity. Okay. If you divide this term, each term by sin square, you will get another identity. 1 plus cos square is equal to cosecant square. You check that. Right, no need to mug up all these identities. You please try to understand the logic. In this, I am dividing by cos square, I am getting this identity. So why you are choosing this identity, sir? Because this is a relation between tan and secant. Okay, so only one tan x is given, it is not possible to find your sine. It is not possible to find your cos. Okay, but using tanx, it is possible to find your secant value, secant x value. Once if you get secant x value, I can easily get it my cos x. My cos is the reciprocal of the secant. That is a secant is a reciprocal of the cos function. I can easily get it. Oh, okay. Yeah, using Pythagoras theorem also you can apply. Using Pythagoras theorem you apply, but here some negative values is given means that is a problem for you. You have to find out carefully. For tan x is equal to 3/4 is means no problem. For negative value means you have to applying Pythagoras theorem carefully. That is a very important one. Okay, so therefore you please. For negative values, positive values, for both the values, this method is okay for you, right? Okay, now come to that. What is my tan x? My tan x is 3/4. So therefore, 1 + 3/4 the whole square equal to secant square x. Okay, so therefore, 1 + 9/16 equal to secant square. Right, 16 + 9, that is 25/16 equal to my secant square x. My secant x is ±5/4 equal to secant x. But my x is lies in the third quadrant. X lies in third quadrant. Given. It is given. My x by 2, look at that. My x is lies in the third quadrant. This is third quadrant. My x by 2 lies in the second quadrant. Okay, but here only x. X lies in the second, third quadrant. In third quadrant, my secant, cosecant, sine, cos, everything is a negative. Tan and cot only positive. So therefore, I am taking negative value because my secant of third quadrant value is negative. Third quadrant angle is negative. Okay, right. Since secant x is -5/4, my cos x is -4/5. So still we are not getting answer. Why? Because the question is cos x by 2. But we are getting cos x alone. Right. How to find out cos x by 2, sir? Just now I have told one result. My cos square x is equal to 1 + cos 2x/2. Are you okay? See that? See here, cos square x is equal to 1 + cos 2x/2. This is cos square x is equal to 1 + cos 2x/2. Okay, so therefore 1 + cos 2x/2. Okay, so replace here in this, replace x by 2. Why, sir? Because I want cos x by 2. Look at that, the question is cos of x by 2. I want cos x by 2. So therefore I am replacing x by 2. So this is 1 + cos 2 × x/2/2. So this is cos square x by 2 equal to, this is 2 to cancel here. Look at that, this 2, we can cancel it. So therefore only cos x. We already know the value of cos x. See that my cos x is -4/5. See that my cos x is -4/5. Apply. So my cos square x by 2 equal to 1 - 4/5/2. So this is nothing but 5 - 4. Cross multiply. 5 - 4, 1/5/2. This can be written as 2/1. So therefore this is 1/5 × 2/1 can be written as 1/2. This is 1/10. My cos square x by 2 is 1/10. Okay, so therefore, which implies my cos square x by 2 is equal to 1/10. Taking square root on both sides, this is ±1/√10. That means root 1 is 1 and root 10 is root 10. Okay, right. But what is my x by 2? My x by 2 lies in the second quadrant. okay, my x by 2 lies in the second quadrant, so therefore my cos of the second quadrant angle is negative only. My cos of the second quadrant angle is negative, no positive. Why? My x by 2 lies in the second quadrant. Okay, so now I got the value of cos x by 2. What is the question? Question is cos x by 2, sin x by 2, tan x by 2. Now I got it cos x by 2. Okay, so once you get the cos x by 2, then go for the sin x by 2. Okay, we know that what is my sin square x by 2? My sin square x by 2 is 1 minus cos square x by 2. Okay, 1 minus, this is minus 1 by root 10, the whole square. What is the answer? This is minus, the minus 1 the whole square is plus 1. This root 10 the whole square is 10. Now simplify. 10 minus 1, that is 9 by 10. My sin square x by 2 is equal to 9 by 10. Taking square root on both sides, because I need only sin x by 2. Question is sin x by 2, but here I am getting the value of sin square x by 2. Plus or minus root of 9. Root of 9 is 3. And root 10. Root 10 only. My x by 2 belongs to the second quadrant. X by 2 lies in second quadrant. Okay, second quadrant means my sin x is positive. Sin of x by 2 is positive only. So therefore, plus 3 by root 10. There is no minus, plus 3 by root 10. That is my sin x by 2. This is another value. Sin x by 2. We got the answer for sin x by 2 also. Okay, now look at the question. Another one, tan x by 2. What is my tan x by 2? My tan x by 2 is nothing but sin x by 2 divided by cos x by 2. What is sin x by 2? 3 by root 10. What is cos x by 2? Minus 1 by root 10. My root 10 cancel. 3 divided by minus 1. The answer is minus 3. This is my tan x by 2. Here, look at that. My x by 2 belongs to the second quadrant. In second quadrant, my tan angle is negative only. Yeah, we are getting negative value only. Tan x by 2 is minus root 3. Sorry, minus 3. Okay, so that is negative. Second quadrant. My x by 2 belongs to the second quadrant. Are you okay? So please try to understand. First of all, use this identity. The first logic is use this identity. If tan is given, use this. If cot is given, use the another identity. 1 plus cot square is equal to cosecant square. So how to remember this identity, sir? Nothing. Here I am dividing this identity by cos square. You divide this identity by sin square, you will get this identity. Divide this identity by each term of this identity by sin square, you will get this identity. If cot x is given, you can apply this. So secant x is given, sir, no problem. Secant x is given means directly you come to cos. Directly you come to the cos. Okay, so once if we get cos, we can easily find out using this formula. We can find out the cos square, cos x by 2. Once you got cos x by 2, come to the sin x by 2 and tan x by 2, everything. Okay. Are you okay? So you have to memorize all the identities and work out more problems. Automatically, you will get an idea. For this problem, we have to apply this identity. For this problem, we have to apply this identity, everything. Okay. So by practice only, we can easily understand which identity we have to apply for this type of problem. Okay. Without practice, it is not possible. Okay. Only practice. Yes, Rajesh, what is your doubt? This week, no master, Harish. Okay, and look at that, this problem. I hope you can understand this problem, all of you. Now look at this problem, example 14. Okay, show that, the question is, show that tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x equal to tan 3x minus tan 2x minus tan x. How to prove this? This is an example problem only. Okay, so how to prove this one? So we know that this tan 3x can be written as tan 2x plus x. Okay, we have a tan x plus y formula. Okay, what is tan x plus y formula? Tan x plus tan y. Okay, 1 minus tan x into tan y. Okay, this is tan x plus y formula. See the identity, tan x plus y identity. I am just applying the tan x plus y identity. Tan x plus tan y divided by 1 minus tan x into tan y. Okay, I am just writing this 3x as 2x plus x. Now just cross multiply. I need this answer. This equal to this. I have to prove that. Just cross multiply. What is the answer? 1 into tan 3x. Minus tan 2x into tan x into this tan 3x. That means tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x. Equal to, right hand side, what is the answer? Tan 2x plus tan x. What we have to prove that? My left hand side is tan 3x, tan 2x, tan x. My right hand side is tan 3x minus tan 2x minus tan x. So therefore, you bring these two terms to the left hand side and this term to the right hand side. What happened? My tan 3x, you bring these two terms to the left hand side. Minus tan 2x, this is minus tan x equal to, you bring this term to the right hand side, plus tan of 3x into tan of 2x, okay, into tan of x. Okay, that's all. Are you okay, Pa? It is very simple. Just apply the formula sin x minus sin y plus cos y formula. 18th sum. Are you okay? The exercise 3.3. 18th problem, sin x minus sin y divided by cos x plus cos y equal to tan of x minus y by 2. Okay, what about your sin x minus sin y formula and cos x plus cos y formula? That is the identity. We need these two identities. If you know these two identities, okay, we can easily answer for this question. What is my sin x minus sin y? So this is 2 cos of x plus y by 2 sin of x minus y by 2. Okay, here minus means here cos, here sin. Plus means here sin, here cos. Okay, what about my cos of cos x plus cos y identity? So this is 2 cos of x plus y by 2. Okay, into cos of x minus y by 2. Okay, just apply the here. You just apply these two identities, you'll get the answer. What is your sin x minus sin y? This is 2 cos of x plus y by 2 into sin of x minus y by 2 divided by cos x plus cos y. This is identity. So 2 cos of x plus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2. Okay, you just cancel this 2 cos of x plus 2 cos of x plus y by 2. Now this is sin of x minus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2. Sin by cos is tan. My angle is same. Sin of x minus y by 2 cos of x minus y by 2. This is answer RHS. Are you okay? Yeah, what is the doubt, Pavan? Kavya, just a minute, I will explain. Which one? Where we are getting caught? Pavan, what is your doubt? Pavan, what is your doubt? From second step, look at that, Pavan. This is formula, tan of x plus y formula. What is my tan x plus y formula? Tan x plus tan y divided by 1 minus tan x into tan y. This is identity. Tan of x plus y identity is there. I will tell the identity name. You please go through the identity. Tan of x plus y, identity number 10. This is identity 10. It is given in your book. You please go through that. Tan of x plus y is equal to tan x plus tan y. 1 minus tan x tan y. I am taking my 3x is 2x plus x. I am taking this is my x, this is my y. Take this is x, this is y. Apply that tan x plus tan y minus 1 minus tan x into tan y. And now you just cross multiply these two. Left hand side is tan 3x is there. You multiply the denominator, you bring this denominator here and multiply 1 into tan 3x, and this is tan 3x into tan 2x into tan x with the minus sign. Numerator, this is the numerator, right hand side numerator, denominator comes to the left hand side and multiplying. Okay, Pavan, any other doubt? Yeah, the proof also important. Okay, you go through all the proof. Okay, so example 26 also it is important. It is example sum only. You please go through the example problems, because if you are asking exercise problems means no problem. You are asking about the example problems again. Okay, no problem. I will do that example problems also. First, I will explain about that. What do you want? 13 and 14. Okay, first of all, I will explain about that general solution and principal solution. Look at that. My general solution is the last class also I explained this general solution. My sin x is equal to 0 implies my x is equal to n pi. N belongs to z. This is my general solution. Okay. My cos x is equal to 0 implies my x is equal to 2n plus 1 of pi by 2 is my general solution. Okay. Okay, pa. I will explain. Don't worry. I will explain, pa. So this is my general solution. Okay, general solution means you apply that. What is your n? N belongs to the integer. Integer means apply 0, I will get x 0. Apply n is equal to plus 1, that is plus pi. Apply n is equal to minus 1, I will get minus pi. apply n is equal to 2 plus 2 pi. Apply n is equal to minus 2 minus 2 pi. Similarly, plus or minus 3 pi. Plus or minus 4 pi. All are solution of this equation. These all values, infinite number of values satisfying this equation. So therefore, this is called as our general solution. What is principal solution? Principal solution means, okay, so my x value between 0 to 2 pi, the solution lies in this interval 0 to 2 pi, 0 included, 2 pi not included. Okay, what are the values, what are the solutions belongs to this interval and satisfying this equation? That is a principal solution of the given equation. Okay, so therefore, so look at that, my sine x is equal to 0. Okay, then what are the principal solutions? My 0 belongs to this interval, my plus pi belongs to this interval, my minus pi not belongs to this interval. Come to this plus 2 pi, my plus 2 pi also not in this interval. Please see that 2 pi not included. My minus 2 pi not included, not in this interval. Plus 3 pi, no. Plus minus 3 pi, no. Plus 4 pi, no. Minus 4 pi, all the remaining values are not in this interval. So therefore, my x is equal to 0, comma pi are the principal solutions. Of sine x is equal to 0. Okay, similarly cos x, right? Okay, sir, you are explaining about sine x is equal to 0, sir. What about sine x is equal to some root 3 by 2, sir? Okay, so sine x is equal to root 3 by 2 means, suppose I will give some other example. Sine x is equal to root 3 by 2. Write the principal solutions of sine x is equal to root 3 by 2. Okay, so principal solutions. Okay, right. So then what happened? This is root 3 by 2 can be written as sine of pi by 3. Okay, my x is equal to pi by 3. What is the principal solution? My x lies in this interval. Yeah, my pi by 3 belongs to this interval. It is correct. Okay, this is my principal solution. So only one principal solution, sir? No, we have one more principal of solution. How to find out, sir? If sine pi by 3 is, that is pi by 3 is the one solution, then take the sine pi by 3. You can write that pi by 3 and go for these three formats. So that is pi plus pi by 3, what is the answer? Sine of pi minus pi by 3, what is the answer? And sine of 2 pi minus pi by 3, what is the answer? Check these three. In these three, which one we are getting sine pi by 3? That is your answer. Look at that. Here, sine of pi plus pi by 3 means, this is, pi is coming means, I have already told that, pi is coming means, don't change the function. This is sine pi by 3. This is also pi is coming, don't change the function, sine pi by 3. Here also 2 pi is coming, 2 pi means don't change the function, that is sine of pi by 3. Okay, right? So, but we have to go for the sine, positive or negative. This is sine of the third quadrant angle. Look at that, this is a third quadrant angle. Pi plus pi by 3 means third quadrant. Sine of third quadrant angle is negative. This is sine of second quadrant angle, positive. This is sine of fourth quadrant angle, negative. Okay, but in these three cases, this one and this one and this one, which is equal to sine pi by 3? In these three cases, which is equal to sine pi by 3? This is the only case equal to sine pi by 3, plus sine pi by 3. But here plus sine pi by 3, here also plus sine pi by 3. These two are minus pi by 3, equal to minus pi by 3. So therefore, this is not applicable, this is not applicable, this is applicable. That means my sine x is equal to sine pi by 3. In place of sine pi by 3, you can substitute sine of pi minus pi by 3. Okay, what is this sine of 3 pi minus pi? That is 2 pi by 3. Here sine x. Here x is equal to 2 pi by 3. Okay, so this is one principal solution. This is one sort of principal solution. This solution also belongs to this interval. This solution is also belongs to this interval. This is less than 2 pi only. Pi by 3 means 60 degree. 2 into pi by 3 means 120 degree. 120 belongs to this interval. So therefore, these are the principal solutions. Therefore, principal solutions are pi by 3, 2 pi by 3. Are you okay? Are you clear? Are you okay, Pa? Are you understanding this? Any doubt? Principal solution, general solution. Okay, so now come to the next problem, example 26. So this is a problem, prove that cos 2x cos x by 2 minus cos 3x cos 9x by 2 equal to sin 5x by 2. We have to prove this. Look at that. For this, we have a formula for cos of x. Please try to understand. The identities are very important. If you are not studying the identity, the problem for you only. We have an identity for cos of x plus y. We have an identity for cos x plus cos y. Okay, we have an identity for 2 cos x cos y. Look at that. 2 cos x cos y. Here cos x into cos y is there. Only 2 is missing. Constant 2 is missing. This is identity 21, I think. Identity number 21. 21 identity. 2 cos x cos y can be written as. See the identity. What is identity? 21st identity. 2 cos x cos y is. What is the answer? Cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y. I am going to apply this identity. We have identity for cos of x plus y, cos x plus cos y. 2 cos x cos y also we have identity. Look at that. This is cos x cos y. Here also cos x cos y. Okay. So therefore, my LHS is to apply this identity, I need 2 here, I need 2 here. So therefore, I am multiplying and divided by 2. So here this is cos 2x into cos of x by 2. Minus here I am writing this is first cos 9x by 2 cos 3x. Okay, now multiply these two inside. This is 2 cos 2x cos x by 2 minus 2 cos 9x by 2 okay into cos 3x. Now apply this identity 2 cos x cos y. What is identity? Cos of x plus y. That means this is your x, this is your y. Add these two. So therefore this is 1 by 2 of okay 2 cos x cos y. Actually this is your x, this is your y. Add these two. What is the answer we are getting? So that is cos of x plus y, 2x plus x by 2. And subtract cos of x minus y by 2, that is cos of 2x minus x by 2. Okay, minus again apply the same identity for this one. Applying this one, what is the answer you are getting? Cos of 9x by 2 plus 3x. Here my formula is plus, but here we have minus. There are two terms, multiply by minus. Therefore, cos of 9x by 2 minus 3x. Please try to understand. I am just applying this identity, that's all. Okay, now simplify, you will get the answer. So if we simplify, what is the answer? We are getting 2x plus x by 2. What is the answer? 5x by 2. 2x minus x by 2. What is the answer? 3x by 2. Okay, here cos of 9x by 2 minus 3x plus 3x. What is the answer? Simplify 2 into 3, 6, 15x by 2. And here 9x by 2 minus 3x means it is 3x by 2. Are you clear? Are you okay? Are you okay, Pa? So Rahul, if you take pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, the function should be changed. Sine change to cos, cos change to sine. But I want only sine pi by 3, which is equal to sine pi by 3, I am expecting. Okay, if you take pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, the sine function change into cos. I never get that sine pi by 3. So look at this one. Here, why I am taking only plus pi, pi and 2 pi? Why am you please think about Rahul, you add your question, one more question. Why sir, you are taking only 2 pi minus pi by 3? Why you are not taking 2 pi plus pi by 3? So 2 pi plus pi by 3 means it is comes to the fourth quadrant. It is not in my principal solution. Look at that, 2 pi plus pi by 3 means that is not in our principal solution. Your x must be less than 2 pi. Okay, as well as that is equal to sine pi by 3 also. Therefore, if you take pi and 2 pi, then only I will get the sine function. If you take pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, you will get a cos function. It will go to cos function. It is not equal to cos pi by sine pi by 3. I need only sine pi by 3. So therefore, in these three values only give some sine, same value sine pi by 3. Okay, but this is also sine pi by 3, but opposite sign. This is also sine pi by 3, but opposite sign. But this is sine pi by 3 with the same sign plus sign. So therefore, these two values are equal. Okay, so therefore, my sine pi by 3 what answer is root 3 by 2. My sine of 2 pi by 3 answer also root 3 by 2. Okay, Pa? Right. Yeah, you please simplify this, you will get the answer. Okay, I will finish this problem only 2 minutes. So the answer is I am getting 1 by 2 of first one is cos 5x by 2 plus cos 3x by 2 minus cos 15x by 2 minus cos 3x by 2. Okay, so therefore, look at that, and this get cancelled. I am getting cos of 5x by 2 minus cos of 15x by 2. Now, you go for this formula. I have already told that cos x plus cos y we have formula, cos x minus cos y also we have formula. Now, go for cos x minus cos y formula. What is my cos x minus cos y formula? Minus 2 times of sine of x plus y by 2, 5x by 2, 15x by 2, by 2. Okay, here also sine of 5x by 2, 15x by 2, minus 15x by 2, by 2. So therefore, you can cancel these 2 and 2, we'll get minus. Okay, minus sine. Here 5x plus 15x, 20x by 2, that is 10x. 10x by 2, that is 5x. Here sine of 5x minus 15x, minus 10x by 2. Minus 10x by 2 means that is minus 5x. Okay, minus 5x, actually minus 5x by 2. And this is a first identity, identity number 1. Sine of minus x is minus sine x. Are you okay? So therefore, this is sine 5x. This is sine of minus x can be written as minus sine of 5x by 2. Minus into minus plus sine 5x, sine 5x by 2. This is your RHS. Are you okay, Pa? Yes. First multiply by 2 because we need 2. Then only we can apply the formula. Kavya, the theorem of general solution. Which one you want? Theorem number 1, theorem number 2, theorem number 3. Yeah. Kavya. That are deleted portion, ma. Repeatedly, I am telling. Every class, I am repeating the same. The theorem 1, theorem 2, theorem 3. Sin x equal to sin y, cos x equal to cos y, tan x equal to tan y. That are deleted. Okay? You concentrate other problems. Right. Thank you all. So tomorrow we will discuss about that first chapter, sets, relation, sets, and then go for functions, relation and functions. Okay, pa? Yeah, I think this is our first slide. Okay. So identities are very important. If you don't know the identity, so it is not possible to solve the problem in trigonometry functions. Okay. First of all, you please go through the identity or at least read the identity twice. First, read the identity and apply the identity, do the problems using identities. Automatically, you will get an idea. Okay. Yeah, thank you all. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Which one, ma? Kavya, what is your doubt? Why you are taking minus 2 pi? That is 2 pi plus theta, ma. I am taking 2 pi minus theta. Here, some student asking that. Here I am taking 2 pi minus pi by 3. Why can't we take it as 2 pi plus theta plus pi by 3? Here I am taking pi plus pi by 3, pi minus pi by 3. But here I am taking only 2 pi minus pi by 3 alone. I am not taking 2 pi plus pi by 3. The reason is it is more than 360. It is not in the principal solution region interval. Okay. Yeah, x will not be a 2 pi. It is less than 0. Yeah, okay, pa. Very good. Thank you, ma. Thank you all. Ajitesh, the problem involving general solution of sin x equal to sin y, cos x equal to cos y, tan x equal to tan y only deleted. Other problems will be there. Okay. Yeah, thank you, everyone. Thank you all. Thank you so much.